अस्सलाम वालेकुम क्लास टू, हाउ आर यू टुडे? इट इज़ योर इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज क्लास. सो व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू डू इन योर इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज क्लास, वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अ न्यू चैप्टर एंड द चैप्टर नेम इज़ द विंड्स इन द विलोज. द विंड इन द विलोज, ओके, यूनिट नंबर 13. बट वी आर स्टार्टिंग दिस चैप्टर फ्रॉम लेसन नंबर 3, ओके. सो फॉर दैट ओपन पेज नंबर 76 ऑफ योर प्रोग्रेसिव इंग्लिश बुक. सो वॉट आर वी हैविंग ऑन पेज नंबर 76 इज लेसन 3, रीडिंग द वाइल्ड वुड. ओके, देर इज अ स्टोरी द विंड इन अ विलोज. दिस आर कंप्लीट नॉवल रिटन बाय कैनेथ ग्राहम. ओके, the novel is written by Kenneth Graham and this is a simplified version of that story. Okay, this is the summary of that story. Okay, this is a short version of that story. Okay, so now we will read it and then we will get to know that what the story is all about. Okay, so I'm starting it and you will put your finger on the first line and repeat every sentence after me, okay, as you do always. Now I am starting. Mole and Rat were good friends who lived in a hole nearby a river. They never went into the wild wood. Rat and had another friend called Mr. Badger, who lived in the wild wood. But Mole did not know him. Okay, what is happening in the first paragraph? There were two friends, Mole and Rat. Okay, they were very good friends who lived in a hole nearby a river. Okay, this is Mole and this is a Rat. They never went into the wild woods. They never went into the jungle. Okay, Rat had another friend called Mr. Badger. This Rat has another friend called Mr. Badger, but Mole didn't know him. Okay, I did like to meet Mr. Badger, said Mole one day. Can we ask him to dinner? Mole was saying that I want to meet Mr. Badger. I like to meet Mr. Badger. Can we ask him, can we invite him to dinner one day? Badger doesn't like go out to dinner, said Rat. What did Rat say? That Badger did not like to go out for dinner. Then let's go and see him, said Mole. So Sale suggests that we will go to Badger to meet. If he doesn't like to go out, then we will go there and we will meet him. Oh no, Badger wouldn't like that at all, said Rat. He is very shy and he lives in the middle of the wild wood. So what the Rat say? That Badger wouldn't like that at all. Badger did not like to go out. Neither Badger like that someone will come and meet him. Why? Because he is very shy and he lives in the middle of the wild wood, middle of the jungle. What's the matter with the wild wood? Asked Mole. Nothing, said Rat. But we won't go now. It's a long way and he won't be at home in the summer. He'll come to see us one day. So Mole is asking that what is the matter in the wild wood? We can go there. Rat say, there is nothing, no matter there, but we won't go now. Why we won't go now? Because it is a long way and he won't be home in the summer. Badger was not home in the summer. Okay, he'll come to us one day. Okay, but Badger did not come to see Rat. Months went by and winter came. One afternoon, Rat was asleep by the fire. I want to see Mr. Badger, thought Mole. So I am going to see Mr. Badger. What did Rat say? That he'll come to us. But Mr. Badger never came to them. And months went by. And summers are over and then winter came. So one afternoon when Rat was sleeping near the fire, Mole thought that I want to see Mr. Badger and I am going to see him alone. Quietly, Mole went out into the cold afternoon and started to walk towards the wildwood. So, without asking to Rat, Mole started to walk to meet Mr. Badger in the wildwood alone. At first, when he reached the trees, he felt fine. But soon it started to get dark. So what happened? At first, when he reached the trees, when the jungle was started, then he felt fine. Everything was fine. But soon when he goes into the jungle gets darker. It started to get darker. Then the faces began to appear. First he thought he saw a face behind him, an evil little face. But when he turned and looked, it disappeared. Then in every hole in the wood, there seemed to be a face with hard, sharp little eyes. Mole was frightened. He left the path to get away from the holes into the ground. And soon he was lost in the woods. So what happened? When the jungle gets darker, when the wildwood gets darker, he started frightening and the faces begin to appear from the every hole of the trees, evil faces. So what happened? He left his path. He knew the path, but he left the path because he was frightened. He left that path where he was walking and then he got lost in the woods. Then the whistling began. At first it was very quiet, but it started to get louder. Mole was a long way from home and night was closing in on the woods. It was cold. So when he was lost in the woods, what happened? Whistling began. Someone whistled. At first, firstly, it was very quiet, but it started to get louder and louder, the whistling. Mole was a long way from home. Mole was very far away from home and the night was very close and it was cold also. Then the pattering begins. Pattering, what is the meaning of pattering? Small drops of rain. He knew that it was the pattering of little feet. So he knew that it was the pattering of little feet. When someone walks slowly or the raindrops when falling softly, it is called pattering. So here the meaning of the pattering is that someone is coming towards him very slowly. Okay, here the pattering means someone is coming towards him very slowly. Were they behind him or in front of him? An animal rushed past him and whispered, "Get out of here, you fool, get out," before it disappeared into a hole. So when he was just supposing that where he is or who was coming, if he is behind me or in front of me, an animal just rushed in front of him. Rushed means just quickly run in front of him and whispered. What he whispered? The animal, "Get out of here, you fool, get out," before it disappeared into the hole. He just rushed quickly and then he disappeared into the hole and just he said to the mole that, "Get out of here." Now the whole wood seemed to be running and mole started to run too. So now what happened? Mole started to run. Mole was very frightened. He ran into the things. He fell over things. He rushed under things and dodged round things. So he ran, he fell. When he was running, he fell over the things. He rushed the thing under the things. मतलब he tugged under the things and he dodged the things. At last he hid in the hollow of an old tree and listened to the pattering and whistling outside. What happened? At last he hid himself into the hole of an old tree, okay, and listening the pattering and whistling outside. Pattering means someone is coming very slowly, and whistling means he was whistling, okay. He wanted to go home, but he was lost. And now he knew why Red never went into the wild woods. Now he realized that why Red never went here and why Red was not coming with me. Now he realized that how big he has done a mistake by coming here in the wild woods. So this is the first part of the chapter, that Mr. Mole has been lost. Now how will he go back to his home? We will get to know this in the next part. But before the next part, we will do this. Read the sentences and circle the correct ending. Choose A, B and C. Okay, like Mr. Badger lived. What is the correct one? You have to circle. Like this, you will do this all. You will read the chapter and you will do this, solve this by yourself, okay? This you will do in the book, okay? Now, we will starting the next part of this story. Turn to the chapter number, page number 80, lesson 6, reading. The Wind in the Willows, part 2, saved. In this part, Mr. Mole will be saved. How he will be saved, we will get to know. So first, read the instruction. As you read the story, put a circle round these marks. You have to circle these marks. This is a apostrophe sign, okay? Like this. This is a apostrophe sign. You have to mark these, okay, with pencil in the chapter. Now I am starting it and listen very carefully, okay? When Rat woke up, he looked for Mole. The house was very quiet. Okay, now this part is from the Rat's house, okay? Mole was in the jungle. Now this part is starting from the Rat's house. When Rat woke up, he looked for Mole, but the house was empty and it was very quiet. Molly, he called. There was no answer. He thought Mole might be in the kitchen, but he was not there. Rat went to the front door and saw that Mole's cap was not on its peg. His boots were not by the door. So when Rat went to the door, he saw that there was no Mole's cap on the peg, the rag through which we hang our caps. And there was no boot by the door. Okay. When he opened the door, Rat saw Mole's footprints in the mud. They led straight to the wild woods. So when Rat opened the door, he saw, what did he saw? Mole's footprints into the mud. And which the footprints are going straight to the wild woods. Rat thought for a moment or two, then he put on a belt, pushed two pistols into it, picked up a big stick and set off for the wild woods. Then Mole, Rat got to know that Mole was in the jungle. So then Rat thought for a moment that jungle was very, the wild woods were very dangerous. But Mole was his friend, so he has to go to rescue Mole. So what did he do? He put his belt, pushed two pistols into it. Okay, he kept two pistols into it and picked a big stick and set off for the wild woods. Okay. It was nearly dark when he got there. A few evil little faces appeared out of holes, but they disappeared at once when they saw the brave Red with his stick and pistols. So what happened? Same things happened with the Red, that the faces appeared, evil faces appeared from the holes. But when they saw the Red with the pistol and he's very brave and he has a stick also, so they disappeared. They gone. Molly, 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 he called. He called Mole. Where are you? It's me. It's old Rat. He was just calling Mole and he was searching him. At last, after an hour, he heard a little cry. He followed the sound of the cry and soon came to an old tree with a hole in it. From the hollow came a tired voice saying, Ratty, is that really you? I have been so frightened. After an hour of searching, Rat finally heard some noises of crying, and then he followed that noise, and then he came to know towards a hollow tree from where the noise is coming out. Then what the noise is saying? The tired noise is saying, Ratty, is that really you? I have been so frightened. Frightened means dara hua tha. I have been so frightened. Main bahut dara hua tha. Yes, it's me, said Rat kindly. I told you not to come here, but I am not angry. Just happy to find you. Now come along. Come along now. We must get home. So, what did the Rat say? That, yeah, it's me. I told you not to come here, but I was not angry. I am just happy that I found you. Now come along. We must get home because it was dark and it was night now. So we must go home now. So in that way, Rat finally found out Mole, and they both went to home. Okay. So you know what has happened in the story, how Mole stuck into the jungle and how Mr. Rat saved him. Okay. So you need to read the stories, both the parts, very carefully, and you will circle these apostrophes. Okay. In this story. Okay. Now in this story you need to do B. This you will do in copy. Complete the sentences. Rat knew that Mole was in the house. Mole was not in the house because. How Rat knew that Mole was not in the house? Because Mole's cap was not on its peg and his boots were not by the door. Right? That is how Rat came to know that Mole was not in the house. Okay? Just like that, you will do all five of these in the copy. Okay? Complete the sentences in the copy. Okay? Now, see, you will do this in the copy. Match these adjectives to animal in the story in lesson 3 and lesson 6. Like frightened. Who was frightened? Mole was frightened. Brave. Who was brave? Mr. Rat was brave. Okay. Who was evil? Who was shy? Who was kind? And who was tired? Okay. You will came to know about these things in the story and you will do this according to the story. Okay. And you will do this in your copy. I hope you understand both the stories, both the part of the stories. And I hope you will do your copy work. I will meet you next time with another video. Allah Hafiz.